Hi, it's Rich Tarani. Thanks for watching TMC Net's Editor's Day Santa Clara 2015. Brett Shockley is with us. Brett, welcome to the show. How are you?
I'm great, Rich. Thanks for having me today.
We're thrilled. I mean, I've known you for decades now, and as an executive at Avaya and Cisco and launching successful companies over the years, and I'm excited to hear from your perspective on just what's happening in the industry and the multiple markets you play in. Why don't you start off by just saying which companies you're involved in right now in their spaces?
Sure. Happy to do that, Rich. And by the way, congratulations on your business. It's been exciting watching you all these years and watch you build the kind of business you've built here as well.
Oh, how nice. Thank you.
The last year I've been doing a lot of consulting and board work. I joined the board of directors for eGain, which is one of the leaders in enterprise digital customer engagement, which has been very, very interesting. I recently joined the board of advisors for Virtual Hold Technologies. I think you had Wes Hayden in earlier, so I've been helping Wes out in that regard. I've been doing some work for a very interesting over-the-top software-based video conferencing company called Fuse. I've been doing work for a couple of different unified communications players, and I've been helping people with some of their strategies to build enterprise contact center businesses and sort of where that industry goes in the future. So I've been involved in a lot of different sides of the industry this year. It's really been fun. You know, I started my first company when I was 14, and this is the first time I've sort of taken a pause and a step back and had a chance to really go look at things from a lot of different angles.
And with your perspective, it's probably of great interest to the audience to learn just basically what you're saying. What do you think, what are some of the trends, what's next, what are some of the things we can expect?
Well, let me pick the contact center world or customer engagement world first. That's an area that I think is going through a tremendous amount of change. You've got about a $22 billion market worldwide, and I would say over the next 5 to 10 years, that market's going to completely flip. It's going to go from premise-based to cloud-based, and you know, one of the things that a lot of people talk about is that, oh, it's going to go from voice to omni-channel. I actually don't think that's true. I actually think that we have to be careful when we start thinking about, hey, let's take a voice ACD and let's add multiple channels on top of it. To me, that's a little bit like if McDonald's goes and hires a big ad agency to do a social media advertising campaign for them. That's kind of an oxymoron, right? That's not the way you do social media. And by the same token, I don't think you just add other channels on top of the same paradigm that drives the typical contact center ACD. You have to take a step back and think about the customer journey, which really doesn't begin with a phone call anymore. It begins with a keyword search. And you have to think about how are you going to orchestrate that customer's journey throughout their life cycle and the way that they interact with you both in an automated fashion as well as with human beings. And those human beings could be through WebRTC through the web. They could be through text chat. They could be through a phone call. You know, there's still enormous value in getting human beings involved. In fact, probably a 15 to 20 times increase in chance of closing business or satisfying the customer if ultimately a human being is involved at the right point in time. And so to get to that, you really need to think about that whole life cycle and how do you orchestrate it. And it's unlikely that any one company is going to have a hold on that whole thing. So federated analytics, big data analytics are going to become a real key to that direction and the ability to bring information in from digital marketing. Software companies to bring information in from contact centers, your databases that are behind your CRMs, public databases, subscription databases like Fair Isaac, FICO, the people that do your credit scores. Bringing that together and being able to federate it in real time and ultimately then being able to orchestrate that customer throughout the life cycle so that at the right moment in time, you're reaching out when they're on the web to offer them some additional help. You're offering them special offers that might drive them to the next point in the process, or you're bringing a human being in to help close the deal.
So basically, we're really like lubricating transactions from start to finish. Mm-hmm. And really, it's almost like an IP packet that has challenges because the network has got congestion, and we're taking out the congestion in the customer journey, and there's lots of it. There are lots of challenges, lots of issues, and lots of opportunities to respond to their challenges on social. So they're upset. We want to make sure that if they're upset, we solve their problem even before they get a chance to complain on social. But if they do complain on social, then you've got to address that, and then you've got to push them down and try to maybe solve that and then remind them that you have some special offers or give them some kind of coupon, and then they go down and they look at the website and they have a coupon, and then you flash an offer and a chat window and just all the way down until they get to the end of the transaction, and then basically hopefully we have more happy customers.
Yeah, and if you take a look at some of the projects that have been done in the industry, both from a support and a sales perspective, you know, you see numbers like a 50-60% increase in customer satisfaction, first call resolution, you know, any kind of metric that we typically measure success by when you apply these kinds of techniques. And right now you basically have silos of companies on the front end doing digital marketing. You have a couple companies sort of trying to do, let's get them from the web to the people in a call center or into a store. You have people doing chat. You have people doing ACDs, hey, we'll handle long lists of emails or chats in a call center. You don't really see that yet coming together very well. And so what I think that means is you're going to see companies coming out of left field that are going to suddenly make a difference in this space. You know, the traditional guys are you know, working hard to try to get up into the cloud. They're traditionally premise-based and sort of living off of those revenues and that maintenance margin. You've got sort of the new cloud players that are kind of over the top, and they're busy trying to catch up with the set of features that, you know, the big three have got. And then you've got sort of these digital guys that are doing their unique things, but they don't really, in a lot of cases, want to talk to anybody,
right?
Or know how to. And so I think because of that, you know, you could just as easily see some company you've never heard of come out of the digital side and to suddenly be a major player. Or you can see one of the big guys that sort of changes their approach that suddenly emerges. It's going to be a very interesting.
Yeah, I mean, I'd say like a company like Slack that no one heard of a few years ago, boom, all of a sudden became a leader in enterprise communications. I mean, it's just shocking.
Yeah, I completely agree. We were taking a look at this a few years ago, and some of the research that I was involved in back in the Avaya Labs work that we did. And the idea of short messaging as sort of the start of the communication is something that's sort of been emerging for some time. You've seen it not just with Slack, but also with a number of the over-the-top guys, WhatsApp, Viber, all those kinds of applications. And you see that as one trend. You also see contextual communications as a really hot thing that's starting to happen. It's showing up in apps all over the place where the way the app behaves, the information it displays, and actually the way the app even looks can change based on the context of, you know, the people that are involved, the content that's involved, what's happening on your calendar, and the conversations that are sort of surrounding all that. All of those things are starting to change the nature of the collaboration, because it's not just about getting us together to talk live. It's more about, you know, quick messages back and forth. It's okay, should we escalate it to the next level? If we do, what kind of content do we need? What people should come into it? And so you're seeing people like Slack on the one hand, who came at it sort of from the developer community and, you know, are starting to expand what their capabilities are from there. You're seeing my friend David Gurley with his company Symphony, which has gotten a lot of funding from some of the biggest banks in the world. And he's basically building a messaging first kind of application that has all kinds of interesting security and redundancy and all the things you can imagine the banks would require. And he's actually building it based on an open source model with all of the investors that are involved in
it. Sure.
So a lot of changes in that world as well.
That's great. Well, you know, Brett, we're looking forward to seeing what you do next. You've had a great career, and I'm sure we're going to see more fantastic achievements in the future. Thanks for being here.
Thanks, Rich. It's a very exciting time to be in the industry. I can't believe the number of new things that are happening, and I think we're going to see just all kinds of disruptive change. It's not about how fast do we get GDP growth anymore in terms of growth in our industry. It's going to be about major pieces of the industry flipping, and that'll drive huge opportunities for some and huge challenges for others.
Agreed. Thanks
Thank
again.
You very much.